Okay, so we're going to go ahead and restructure this program a little bit to use our new secure functions. You can see I've got them here, the three functions we were working on in those quizzes. Let's go ahead and use them. So the first thing I want to do is we're not going to store this visits in a variable called visits anymore. We're going to call it visitCookieVal equals getVisits. Okay, and we're going to make a new variable for our actual visits count, which is going to be by default be 0. And then we say if visits cookie val, basically if it's not none, because get will return none if that cookie doesn't exist at all, which is what's going to happen if the user's never been to us. We're going to run our check secure val on this visit cookie stir. I renamed this variable to visit cookie stir. And the result of that, we're going to start in cookie val. And if cookie val, remember that function returns none if it wasn't valid. If cookie val visits equals int cookie val. So we set visits to 0 by default. We look up our cookie. If we have a cookie at all, we try to decode it using check secure val. And if we got a result back from that, that's our valid result. We convert it to an integer and we store it in visits. So visits is either 0 or what we got in the cookie. We don't need to check anymore if it's a digit because we're going to assume it's valid. So we're going to say visits plus equals 1 because now we know it's valid. Nobody's tampered with it. This integer should have worked. Now we need to update our new cookie value. So we call our makeSecureVal function. We've got to convert visits to a string before we send that in. And then we're going to send that to our header. OK, so we made these changes. Let's go to our browser and give it a try. So we're in our browser. We load our page. The visit cookie has whatever we left in it before, 10,001 or something, which isn't going to be valid because there's no hash. So we reload the page. And we start seeing our counter. But you can see our feature is working now. You can see our counter is working. If we look at our cookie, you can see it now stores the number. And it has the hash. Notice it's got a pipe here. Actually, I noticed there's a little snafu with Google App Engine when I was working on this where a comma in a cookie has some special meaning. So I changed our function to use the pipe character instead of a comma because I was getting a bug where my cookie stir didn't have anything after the comma. So I switched from commas to pipes, and that's what we'll use for the rest of this lesson. Back to our browser. We can see that we have this cookie. If we were to mangle this cookie a little bit by saying visits equals 10,001, and then we'll use that same hash like this, 10,001, and reload the page, it resets us back to 1 because our cookie wasn't valid, or at least the number in the cookie didn't match the hash. So because the check secure val failed, we reset visits back to 0. Or actually, we never set it to what its true value is.